Looking for recruiting news you can use? Welcome to Recruiting Headlines, powered by recruitingheadlines.com, a short news segment for recruiters who need to know. Today's episode is sponsored by RecTech Live, on-demand and live webinar learning for recruiters. Go to RecTechLive.com to access past shows and see what's coming.
I'm Chris Russell. Welcome to the Recruiting Headlines. So first up, just a reminder, next week I'm holding a webinar with folks from Uncommon.co. In this free one-hour webinar, which is titled How to Activate Your Passive Talent with Qualification-Based Screening, we'll learn how qualification-based screening beats Boolean by 4x in terms of accuracy and time savings. We'll talk about how recruiters are getting a 50% better response rate from passive talent through qualification-based screening. And you'll see a demo of Uncommon, and you also get a free code to try Uncommon for free for a certain time period. I'll be joined by CEO of Uncommon, Ted Greniger, and we'll talk about best practices around that, followed by a demo of their new platform that delivers only qualified interested candidates and meets your job's custom qualifications. So come check that out. It's Thursday, October 25th, 1 p.m. Eastern. Just head over to rectechlive.com to sign up. All right, interesting, bunch of interesting news stories in the news this week. We've got funding, we've got Indeed, we've got Uber, and some new launches as well. So let's get to it. We'll start with ConveyIQ, which is based out of New York City. ConveyIQ started as Take the Interview, a video interviewing platform, but eventually morphed into essentially a full suite applicant tracking system, recruiting software, whatever you want to call it. They just closed a $5.5 million round of financing to fuel their growth. And they also added Larry Murph as the CEO. ConveyIQ, according to their blog post, the leading provider of enterprise talent communication and recruiting automation software, announced it's closed a $5.5 million round of funding led by SC Ventures with participation from existing investors, 3TS Capital Partners, Starvest Partners, and other current investors. The funding will help drive ConveyIQ's leadership position and rapid adoption by fueling sales and marketing, new product expansion, and the partner ecosystem. The company claims over 140 enterprise clients that currently work with them. So I've known ConveyIQ since they were TTL. They were started out of Talent Tech Labs in New York City. And congrats to them, Danielle Weinblatt, their CEO, and the others. Great job, and look forward to future good things from ConveyIQ. All right, in a press release over on Recruiting Headlines, we have Clara Labs, which just announced their new interview scheduling system. So the press release reads, Clara Labs, a human-in-the-loop scheduling service powering growing teams, announced back-to-back coordination, a new feature designed to address one of the most significant pain points in the recruiting process, scheduling sequences of interviews. Nearly 25% of recruiters spend over 5 hours a week on scheduling, back-to-back coordination searches, multiple calendars to quickly schedule a sequence of interviews while allowing the recruiter to remain in control of the overall candidate experience and interview structure. By using Clara to schedule, send reminders, and manage follow-ups, recruiters can focus their efforts on building stronger relationships with candidates. So Clara Labs is out of San Francisco. Had not heard of them until I saw this press release. They were founded in 2014, and they've been building a sophisticated approach that combines smart software with a human team, giving recruiters the precision and efficiency of machine learning and the professionalism and judgment of scheduling experts. So their URL is, I think it's claralabs.com if you want to check them out. All right, next up, we have a Google for Jobs standalone solution that just came out. It's called Jobiak, J-O-B-I-A-K, out of Wilbur, Mass., created by, I guess, a guy who used to work at Monster, who sold a company to Monster called Gozaic, if you remember that one. It says the Jobiak, the provider of the industry's first AI-based recruitment marketing platform, specifically for Google for Jobs, announced the launch of its flagship platform for recruiters and talent acquisition teams to directly publish their jobs to Google for Jobs. Now, in just 3 steps, users are able to directly access candidates on Google for Jobs, accelerating candidate flow and reducing the cost and time to hire. Currently, the process for posting jobs to Google for Jobs requires deep coding experience and access to the page code for every job. Jobiak's platform scans job posts, identifies the attributes that Google wants, and then restructures them into the Google tags, all without touching the underlying code. So I checked it out briefly. Basically, you put in the URL, and the system then goes and basically reworks the page into the proper Google coding. The pricing for it is pretty cheap. I think it was like, I don't know, $49 or $99 for a certain number of jobs. So it might be worth checking out. Not sure how good it is. But jobiak.com is the URL. And again, you can see the press release on recruitingheadlines.com. All right, two more interesting stories. And this is kind of a little bit related to Google Jobs a bit, but Indeed is cracking down on staffing companies. So, you know, they first basically turned off any organic listings for job boards, you know, back in the mid-2010s. The job board I used to run it as well was cut off, I think, back in like maybe 2014, 2015. Now they're doing the same thing to staffing firms in their quest to basically become an employer-only job search engine. So they put out a policy on their support site that was making the rounds on Facebook and Twitter this week. It says, as of January 7th, 2019, all recruitment-based companies and accounts in the United States and Canada will be required to sponsor their jobs in order to receive visibility on Indeed. So it's pay to play now for you staffing agencies. Companies and accounts affected by this policy may include, but are not limited to, recruiting firms, placement firms, or headhunters who search for, recruit, and place job seekers into roles at other companies, or staffing agencies or outsourcing solutions who employ job seekers directly to perform tasks, duties, and or work that the company has been contracted to fulfill by its clients. So if you're, you know, if you're a big agency and you're recruiting for like an Amazon warehouse, I guess that means you. Please note it says that companies or accounts may be categorized as a recruitment-based company at the sole discretion of Indeed and may be subject to this policy if so. Indeed further reserves the right to acquire sponsorship for jobs for any reason. So it's their way or the highway. The purpose of this, Indeed says, is to continually strive to provide the best possible job search experience for our job seekers. Indeed gives preference to content posted directly by employers and works to provide unique, good quality job advertisements that connect job seekers directly to employers. So, you know, as someone who kind of, you know, was one of the first job boards on Indeed back in when they started, this is really, you know, Indeed cracking down on anybody else other than employers. You know, they're expanding their other product lines to compete with staffing agencies. And so they're basically just narrowing their focus here and excluding you guys from the mix here. So there's not much you can do other than, you know, do things like get on Google Jobs, which is basically the replacement now for free listings. You know, use things like the Facebook job board, which is free. You know, even start your own job board. I did a webinar, which you can go find at rectechlive.com, on why staffing agencies should start their own job boards to control their own destiny, if you will. I think having your own job board for whatever niche you're recruiting in. I'm working with a company now who's in construction staffing, and they're building their own construction staffing, construction job board, essentially. It's a platform they can control. It drives lead gen for them in both candidate and employer type of leads, and it gets them on Google for jobs by using some of the third-party job board software out there. And so I think any staffing agency out there it's in their best interest to kind of, you know, create their own channels for employer and candidate lead gen these days. And that means, it could mean, you know, starting your own job board overall. So Indeed doesn't care about you anymore. So in fact, they're competing with you on a number of levels in the staffing space. So to me, it just makes sense that any kind of recruiter, you know, independent recruiter or staffing agency that focuses on a particular niche, create their own job board and, you know, controls their own destiny here. I would even suggest that staffing firms band together and build their own aggregator overall, you know, the Indeed of staffing, if you will. That would be an interesting site to have and to use as a as an industry overall. So something to think about out there. But Indeed is no longer your friend, and you know, it's probably a matter of time before they don't even want the sponsored listings from you guys. So just be ready, because that's probably going to happen, I think, as Indeed grows and gets out there. I guess they don't want your money anymore. But and finally, in the news, Uber is a big story on TechCrunch this week. They are reportedly developing a short-term staffing business to offer independent contractors for events and corporate functions. Dubbed Uber Work, the article says, the service will provide waiters, security guards, and other temporary staffers to business partners, a source close to Uber told TechCrunch. Uber has been working on a project for several months in Chicago after first trialing the project in Los Angeles. They already have a vast network of drivers, all of whom have become familiarized with their process of filing taxes as independent contractors who may be looking for additional work. Uber Works falls under the purview of Rachel Holt, who stepped into the role of head of new modalities in June. She is tasked with ramping up and onboarding new mobility services like bikes, scooters, car rentals, and public transit integration. In a job posting for a general manager to lead special projects in Chicago, Uber says, our business is based around providing a flexible on-demand supply for our business partners. It's imperative that we have intuitive and responsive account management to support our business partners in addressing the needs promptly. Uber declined to comment for the story, but it says the company is gearing up for its initial public offering next year, and they are clearly trying to diversify its business. So, interesting move here from Uber. You know, they already have the infrastructure built around sort of on-demand staffing with the drivers. So I think it makes sense for them from a line of business here. It's I do worry a little bit that they're going into too many lines of business. So, their reach, their size definitely makes them a player if they launch this thing. So keep an eye out for this, and it's going to affect the other gig players out there, like Wonolo, ShiftGig, some of these new apps that are out there higher. So one to watch here, and the other players in the space could really be affected here if Uber goes into this staffing model here, and who knows, they could expand outward beyond that as well in terms of other freelance stuff. So something to watch, and you can find that article over on TechCrunch. All right, I'm Chris Russell. That's it for the news this week. I'll see you soon. Take care.
That's it for now. Be sure to sign up for our daily newsletter that delivers all the day's top stories every afternoon direct to your inbox. Subscribe at recruitingheadlines.com.